Pomeranian cookie. Now I'm out here in Mississippi. DeSoto, if I'm not mistaken. Just looking for the bayou that's out here. And there's some trail markers. I don't know if that leads to the bayou, but I have to keep my mind on these trail markers to get out this thing. I got flagging, so if I need to flag my own color, I can. But I'm looking for the bayou. This is a nice, good area, but it is a very wet and soggy area. Good for camping if you're going out here to hunt. I'm kind of also not far from Donnie. Donnie's not far from me. Where his camping and his campsite is. So only thing I'm going to do is find the bayou. This is a nice area to camp in. If you're a hunter, look at that. Let's see, that looks like the bayou. Something's over there. See a clear path? Let's find out. Look, another clear path over there. And some more flagging. All right, gotta go that way to get out. So I'm gonna try to stay on this flagging road trail here. So I won't get lost myself unless I get my flagging out to flag my own trail. Because most people flag trails to get to a certain point that they like to go to. See, there's a flag in there. I thought I saw one over here. Let's get to over here in this open area. I do believe this is a hunter's trail. I see something over there. Let's go over there and find out what that is. I'm pretty low as find a flagging. There's a flagging. Keep that in mind. Always remember, look back time to time, because you don't know who let what out here in these woods. Very low, all right. Gotta go between those trees. There's plenty of flagging out here, but you never know what you're gonna find or see out here. There's some deer, baby. Bunch of thorns. Here's another one. I don't want to go too far because I don't see no more flagging. But I have to go that way to get out this thing. Let's take a look what this is. It's just a clearing. See, the reason why I always look back when I'm into untreaded territory, people let pythons out into the woods. There's panthers out here, bears. So I have to always keep my eye out on creatures like that, because you never know. Even though I'm in Mississippi, creatures like that do lurk. And keeping your eye out behind you time to time will might save your life. Because a snake can get big out here and can stalk you. And you will not know he's behind you until it's too late. That's why I have my Kalon blade, a knife I can pull out real quick. Another knife I can dig out if I drop my other tools. Because untreated territory is very dangerous. Very, very dangerous. Because you don't know what's out here. Somebody could have, like I said, dropped off a python snake out here and had fed and got very, very big. I don't know what's out here. So I'm always keeping my eye out behind me. I've learned some lessons over through time, watching videos, watching movies. What a snake and animals do to stalk your ass. But take a look at the woods, how beautiful this is out here. Alright, I'm gonna take a little recess. I'll be right back. So, Ranger Cookie, what are you doing way out there in the middle of nowheres?
Well,
Donnie's looking for a new place to make a new camp. So I came out to do a recon for him. He didn't ask me, I just wanted to do it. Because friends do that. The community help one another. Like that. Okay, so I have to go through there, across that, and I'm back in my other trail. There's no more flagging. I got my flagging out just in case I need to flag a few places. But I'm trying to keep my eye out where I'm at. Locations, this is a good point. If I can find this, I can find myself out. See this little thing right there? Memory. Memory is very important when you go out in the woods. Because you never know, like this tree, you might need that memory of where this tree is, how to get to this tree. Do I never see this tree? So you take a photographic picture in your mind. Tick, tick, tick. You know, every time I do that, I always remember this tree. I'm come out here 10 years and find this tree. All right, looks like the bayou is not nearby, but this looks or feels like it used to be the bayou. I don't feel like going no further because I'm away from the flagons. So I'm gonna head back and I wanna show you the woods that I have explored. Take a watch, take a view. Oh, this vest I'm wearing, boy, I love this vest. It's way better than that other system I had with the little pouches in the back, pounding the hell out of me. I enjoy this vest. This vest is awesome. You know, I went to a store, like Baton Rouge. It's the Baton Rouge police store, and they had the same vest. You know how much they went for this damn vest? $111. And I bought this at my army surplus for $48. Boy, people try to scam me these days. Probably got it for no more than 20 bucks. Retail and selling it and keeping it. They probably, you know, they have to raise the price. They have to make a living and make a profit. So, but $111, that's overkill. All right, back to the woods. This is good hunting grounds. All right, look at that. Look at that tree. It's all twisted and mangled. All right, let's see if we can find some flagging. All right, there's my tree. There's another tree I pointed in my head. This one over here. And all these cool trees. Damn, look at this. Look how pretty this is. This is like a Stonehenge or something. Bunch of trees on a big circle. Look how pretty this is. good, good hunting grounds. And with this vest, I have my saw, two knives, a cooking device so I can cook food. So, only thing I don't have is food or some type of sleep. I need to put an emergency blanket in here, but I don't know if I'm gonna be using an emergency blanket. Depends on where I'm going. Like if I got lost in here, I definitely need a mercy blanket. That baby. Hello, Miss Spider. Hey, hey. Woof. He's now a whooping spider. I can't make it bark. Well, looks like I didn't need my tape after all. I'm back where I started from. I follow the tapes. Here's one of the little landmarks, a little burnt stope. So I'll be out of here in no time. So I hope you enjoy this little walk I have in the middle of the woods. Something somewhere new in Mississippi. So I'm heading back to my car. I don't know if Donnie might not like this area, or he might like this area. So I'm going to find another area for him up the road and see if he likes that area. Alright, I'm go ahead and see y'all later. I hope y'all enjoy this cool hunting grounds. See you next video, Mama Murray! Alright. That's a big bitch. Now these woods, up there, man, come down. Well, I hope you enjoy that little run through the woods. I'm ready to go to another spot where it'd be more safe for my friend Donnie. Come down. Wait, watch me. Come down here, watch me. So I'm going to find another spot for Donnie. This is one of the areas I tried to see if, like, you know, we had to worry about parking. Safety when we searching for a new campsite that's in the middle of the woods. So I don't know about this place. Look at that. Look at all the oak trees along that line. That's where it gets wet. If you ever watch or notice when people cutting trees like this forest here, look at it. They never, never cut around water sources, like a ditch. But you can see that ditch line or that water line that they created. If you notice, all that's thick because they do not cut live oak. It's against the law. Some states, depends on the size of the oak. But it looks like there's a water ravine runs around this whole area. And they usually don't go in there because it's really soupy, it's sloppy. When I was walking in that area, it was like really like wet. And most companies don't want to get their tractors stuck because it costs them an arm and a leg to get them out or whatever they have to do to get the suckers out. So they don't cut there, they leave it. Or property line. Sometimes it's a property line. What are you doing? Look at me. a property line or ditch line. And usually that's when they don't cut. See, look at that. See how thick that is? It's like a ditch there. It goes all the way around. Alright, I'm Ranger Cookie. I hope you enjoyed this short video. More on the other spot that I'm going to in this video right now. Well, I'm Ranger Cookie. And I'm going, this is part two of looking for the bayou. So, according to the Google I did, taking this trail that I'm on now, should take me close enough to the bayou that I want to do some research. So come along with me. Let's do research. Let's take a look at this vast valley of the death. Alright. Take a good look. And once again, I'm in an area I do not know about. I don't know if there's bears. Even though this is Mississippi, they might have one or two bears and maybe a black panther or some wild cat would tear the hell out of me. So, time to time, I look behind me. Because you never know something big and scary is behind you until it's too late. You've already been mauled or cut open or captured by a snake or something. Even though we might not have big pythons out here, but you never know, somebody let one go. Florida, I think 2005, we found a big reptile that swallowed that alligator. But the alligator was so big and the scales were so tough that the snake's acid in its belly couldn't dissolve it fast enough. So the gator swelled in his belly and exploded him. And if it could swallow an alligator, it was, I think it was like 10 foot alligator or bigger or smaller, maybe. I'll have to do research on that. So I'm just taking a wild guess how big that gator was. But it was in Florida. They found the big reptile out there, two reptiles, a snake ate a big alligator, but the gator was so old that, like I said, the scales didn't eat, you know, the acid didn't eat the scales fast enough before the alligator expanded it with gas and exploded the snake. So I'm always keeping out a lookout. I got my knife, got another knife, and like I said, this would be the worst one to grab. The worst one for for being the opposite end of this thing. Think about it. The smallest knife we got is the mower and this one. But if I pull this baby out, let's take a look how big this thing is. And this thing, brand new, will cut the hell out of you. It went through a glove of mine. Cut the hell out of me. But it got a little dull over time. But I got length now. And this would tear up anything. Anything. Even though it's dull, it still got its kick. And it will hurt the hell out of you. So if I'm in a dangerous situation that I need a weapon real quick, that's my saw. So don't mess with me. I've been watching too many videos and too many things to see. No, that's not going to happen to me. Look. Deer. Or wild cat. No, no. Wild pussy cat out here. So, like I said, when I go venture into new woods I'm not familiar with, I got my weapons on me. In case some asshole wants to fuck with me, I got that tapeworm. I use an old curse, sorry for that. Jackass is a better word for it. Damn jackasses. And yes, that's in a dictionary. Jackass. Oh, look at this shit. Holy s... That better be a tent or a tarp. Now, who the hell will leave a good tarp out here? Two of them. All right. So any jackass try to threaten me or fight me or in the middle of the woods, they got them. You never know when somebody's on dope and they come out here and threaten your life. Cause this is the woods, and most people come out here and do that crap. Just in case they want to mess with me, I have something for them. So all I do is put my hand in this loop. They keep them from grabbing my own weapon against me. And just hold it there. All right, take a look at the woods. This trail's been well used. Looks like somebody's going to the bayou. So let's find out where this goes. I know it goes to the bayou. And this was supposed to be a bike trail. So we're going to follow the bike trail all the way back to the trail. Let's see. Look, there's the bike trail right there. Now it looks like this ends. But according to my knowledge, this is the yellow bike trail that I need to take now. That should take me to where I need to go. Yeah, the road in right there. So this trail should take me to the closest to the bayou, and it should remain onto the bayou for a period of time until it gets to where I want. I want to see the bayou. I'm looking for Donnie's new camping area. Give him a little hand, a little reconnaissance. So Donnie, I know you're watching this video, because it's going to have your name in it. Take a watch and see if you like this area, because I'm going to explore it for you. I love to do the recon. I love recon. Gets me out the house. Gets me out in the woods to use my tools and my gear. Like I said, only thing I'm missing on this thing is emergency blanket or some type of sleep system. I see those emergency blankets could be used, especially that red one, as a tarp. That can't be the bayou. Oh, look at this. And the trail goes back to where I don't want to be. All right. What is that over there? Power line. It's supposed to come real close to the bayou. I'm gonna see if I can get me a GPS on a phone so I can really look and find out where I'm at. This kind of sucks. GPS, I think that goes that way. Goes to the bayou, because look at the tree line. I'm trying to look for an opening. I hope this don't take me back where I don't want to go. Let's find out. I was saying, this gets me out the house to go do recon. And it's fun to do too. Helping another community fella out. That's Donnie Paolini, is the first one towards me. By the way, I hope y'all been enjoying Roy's archery shop videos. See, I do make a lot of videos and I put it on my YouTube and I lock them. And two times right, I'll unlock them. So time to time you see some video that's like maybe 3 or 4 months old. The date's at the bottom when I made it or put it on YouTube. So how y'all like Roy's archery shop? You know, I forgot to give you an intro about him. I've been going there for many, many years at Roy's archery shop. And I might show you the video for that if y'all want. Show you the shop a little bit more, you know, more close up to the... Woo-wee! Imagine riding your bike on this crazy. It hits sand. Alright, back to the topic. Sorry. I got a video called The Intro of Roy. If y'all are interested to see more about Roy and how long I've been there, just let me know. I'll put it on. That's about it on Roy. Like I said, I've been going there for many years. I buy a lot of stuff from him. He's a small community. Instead of going to Walmart, go with him. Go to a family man or family gal and buy from them instead of buying from a big corporation. That way he can feed his family, pay the rent, pay the bills. That's why I like going by Roy's. Alright. Enough yak-yakking. So I'm trying to find a bayou. I hope I'll get to it close. Sometimes you can tell when you're getting close by the bayou. Sometimes you can't. You have to look for tree lines. And other signs. Alright, look. It looks like the bayou way out there. Is that down there? Way over there. What's this? There's a trail going down. I bet you I can find the bayou that way. But the bigger part is supposed to start on the other side. So let's go over there. Alright, I'm making this video too long. So see you in a few minutes. Don't be a